can't buy. It resides between my eyes. Walked through the fire, came out better on the other side. See, life's like a beach if you find the sand. And right now, I'm feeling like $100,000.
You are listening to Inspired Insider with your host, Dr. Jeremy Weisz.
Dr. Jeremy Weisz here. I'm founder of InspiredInsider.com, where I talk with inspirational entrepreneurs and leaders like the founders of P90 X, Baby Einstein, Atari, many more, how they overcome big challenges in life and business. Today, I'm excited to have Ajay Prasad. He's founder of GMRTranscription. They have over 9,000 clients, including the FBI, AT&T, and McDonald's. They provide transcription and translation services and run their seven-figure business with 3 employees and over 250 independent contractors. AJ, thanks for joining me.
I'm glad to be here.
You know, since Inspired Insider, what's been the lowest point in how you pushed through, and then what's been the proudest moment?
You know, the lowest point, frankly, was all these unhappy customers for GMRTranscription. And at the same time, because like I told you in the beginning, anyone who walked in, I took them as a client. I had so many, I would say, problem clients, more than not unhappy, but problem client who wanted too much of my attention. So in 2005, you know, that was the time frame where I almost was thinking that maybe I should freshen up my resume. You know, it's not the right thing for me to do. And it continued in 2006. And then luckily, what changed my perspective is the company that had fired me, it was bought out by another company, and it just so happened that the new VCs knew me personally. So they contacted me and they say, hey, you know, would you be interested in coming back as a CEO? So as you can imagine, it's a big boost.
Big opportunity.
That more than, you know, it was, of course, it was a big ego boost that, you know, they fired me and now the same company is asking me whether I would be interested. And they were not offering. They said, if you're interested, then you can throw your hat in the ring. If you want to come in as a senior VP, you have a job. And so I went and talked to my wife and I told her about this thing. And her reaction was, so what would you do after 2 years when you're fired again?
Wow.
Or when they let you go, they are sold or whatever happens, which is what the tenure of a typical CEO is these days. So that's when I said, you know, I have to really go back and work on it. So from high, then I the resolution came and said, no, I have to really help it.
So your wife gave you a reality check.
Big time.
And what did you say? What did you say to her when she said that?
I just looked at her and I'm like, you know, I'm so stupid. How come I didn't think of this? And so that was the end of that discussion. And then like, okay, I have to do this. And then the high point was obviously when we started for GMRTranscription, when it hit 7 figures, you know, that was a huge thing that we celebrated. And, you know, for my GMR web team, we have many high points. You know, when we recently signed up with a really major client here. When I'm saying major, they are like maybe $20 million company, but literally they are going to be completely, they are dependent on us for the whole backend processes and everything and marketing. You know, we international company we hired, and I had promised them that they will break even at least by the end of the year of the relationship, because it was a large company, and second month of the relationship, they were breaking even on my cost. So those are,
it's free leads.
That was, and that was also such a big relief, because then I knew that I have this client, and it always helps to be able to tell people, and I also give them their name as a reference. When to my, you know, prospective clients. So those are kind of high points.
So what do you do, AJ, to celebrate? So you hit 7 figures. What do you do?
So what we do is over here, we would party. So when, you know, recently when we signed this big client, we said, hey, okay, let's just close the office, just change the voice message. And we went out for 3-4 hours to Benihana and partied there. You know, depending on what happens on transcription, we we did some bonus for the staff, and so first thing, we party. Anything that good happens, I love to party. So sometimes we'll just bring in food over here and enjoy. Sometimes we go out, but we do that, and then reward the people, because I don't do anything. Like I told you, I'm just kind of facilitator. So I know that all the success is happening because of the people working for me.
Yeah.
So I reward them whenever something good happens.
Yeah. AJ, this has been really valuable. I appreciate you explaining your process and in the behind the scenes. What work should we leave people with? What should they start doing now if they do have a business and they want to increase sales and make it run smoother?
So, of course, first thing I always say, if you are starting a business, until you have sold, the three steps I told you, it's not a validation, it's not a real business. But once you have a real business, then I always tell people that now it's your time to sit down and kind of almost like draw your ideal customer. And once you draw the ideal customer, then you start to figure out how to reach them, because you will know where they go to, what platform they are on, where they are located and all that. And then come up with the pro plan. And the best thing for any plan to test is do AdWords, because very cheaply you can test the success of it.
Yeah.
For that. So that's where once you start to sales start to happen. I did it very late. I'm telling you, I'm telling you from a mistake, that it is so important to identify your ideal customer as soon as possible. I always tell people, even when you are starting, identify that, because that will reduce a lot of heartburn later on.
Yeah, that's great. AJ, thank you so much. Everyone should check out GMRTranscription.com and GMRWebTeam.com. Oh. Thank you so much, AJ.
Thank you. What I got, you can't buy. It resides between my eyes. Walked through the fire, came out better on the other side. See, life's like a beach if you find the sand. And right now, I'm feeling like 100 grand.